Next up is My Goals. My Goals is the employee access to the performance management module of Brio HR. You will see this access once again from the employee self-service page of Brio HR, your homepage, if your company has subscribed to the performance management module and if you have been given access to it. In My Goals, you will have all the information about performance management in a very clean and organized way, easy to access and understand. On the top, you will see which performance cycle are you currently in. In our example, first half of 2022. You can name it the way you want. This will be led by your HR. On the right-hand side, you will see the timeline of this performance management cycle. First, you see the first day of the cycle until the last day. So in our example, 1st of Jan until the 30th of June. And on this timeline, you will see the key milestones: confirming the objectives, performing self-appraisal, manager appraisal, and so on. Below, in this menu here, you can navigate across objectives, which are the view of the KPIs and or OKRs, depending on what your organization is using, competencies, training plan, appraisal form, and one-on-one feedback. Let's first start with the objectives. The objectives will once again list all your individual KPIs and OKRs, as well as those which are common to a group of people, for example, a department or even company-wide. Objectives can be categorized as per your company framework. In this example, we have professional objectives, positive mindset objectives, behavioral objectives. Of course, those are just examples, and your company can create the categories they need. You can filter by clicking on one of those tags, or you can go back to having the full list under your eyes. Now you can see that we have three objectives, one under each category, and at a glance, we can see the progress. 83%, 100%, 100%. Of course, if you have progress status, which is closer to 0%, 10%, 20%, this will appear in red. The idea is to give you a very quick, at-a-glance view of the progress status of the overall objectives so that you know on which you can focus. For each objective, you will be able to define some key results and qualitative goals, or a mix of those. It's up to you to have one or as many as you want key results. Once again, those objectives are often discussed between yourself and your managers at the beginning of the performance cycle. In this example, we have a professional objective, which is implement digital marketing program. I see that there are three key results and one specific task, and I can actually expand to see the details of it. First, increase social media presence coefficient in Facebook, Instagram, and LinkedIn. And the target is 10. Blog pages to set up. I have to set up to 3. Perform a digital marketing report. I have to perform 1. And write 6 articles for each of the blog pages, which I can tick when I have completed. Here, you can see then the progress that you can update as you go. Currently, the progress is 3 out of 10, so 30% for that specific key result, 100%, 100%, 100% for the 3 others, which we have completed, 3 out of 3, 1 out of 1, and ticked. What you can do is to come in and at the frequency of your choice, and maybe once again, as per the company policy, you can update your key results on a weekly basis, monthly basis, quarterly basis, up to you. You can come in at any time and say, oh, but actually, I have made some progress on this one. So it's not 3 anymore, it's 6. Before we validate, let's see what happens here. So now that we have increased our performance or progress from 3 to 6, this specific key result has also increased this progress calculation to 60%, which gives a higher blended progress for the overall objective from 83 to now 90%. Okay, so that helps you really communicate in an asynchronous way with your manager or your direct reports, because every employee will be able to access their own page and their manager will also be able to access it. In addition to updating the results, you can actually leave comments. And when you write a comment, it will actually appear in the little side panel with all the information that you want to happen. In this case, we have a comment that was written by Jack. I will focus on part XYZ for the next few weeks. So in this section, there is a mix of automated log of all the changes made on the objectives, meaning that you can easily track the progress of the objectives since the beginning. It will be automatically logged when you change from one number to another. And in addition to that, it will contain any comment that you want to share that will be easily readable and viewable by both the employee, the manager. This is really to help make the end of year or end of quarter or end of cycle performance management review as easy and as smooth as possible. The second one is the competencies. In some cases, your company will have a competency framework. In those competency frameworks, you can have a lot of different competencies categorized also across specific angles that they are covering and with different levels as well. Usually the levels are in correspondence with your job grades. So level one will usually be for entry level, up to level 3, 5, I've seen up to 20 going for the senior management. In this case, depending on your department, depending on your level, Brio HR will automatically pick from the competency framework and assign the right competencies with the right levels, meaning the right expectations that correspond to you. In this case, we see two sample categories, core competencies and people skills. And I see that I have a total of 4 competencies applying to me. I even see that the competencies weightage when it comes to the performance evaluation is 50%, meaning 50% competencies in total and 50% KPIs in total. Now I have the list of competencies. I see, for example, that in terms of core competencies, one is fosters collaboration, accountability and dependability, ethics and integrity. I see also some people skills, such as interpersonal skills. For each, not only I see the competencies that apply to me, but I also can see the expectations for me. What do I need to achieve? What do I need to master to be considered up to par with the expectations for my level, in this case, level 2? If I want to go further, I can even see the different levels, meaning I see level 1, which is supposedly the level more junior to me, which has a different set of expectations for a given competency. So I can see what I'm supposed to already have mastered. The second one is highlighted because it's level 2. It's my level in this example where I see my current expectations. So I need to make sure that I master this. But even more interestingly, I actually can see the expectations for the next few levels. So if I want someday to pretend to a promotion or something, I know that I first need to demonstrate some or all of these traits before I actually can talk to my management, which is very interesting because often we lack visibility. In this case, Brio HR allows you to have full visibility, so it's very clear what you need to work on and accomplish. The next one is the training plan, which is simply a list of training that you need to complete as you go through this performance cycle. You can have as many as needed, once again, determined by yourself upon request or maybe from your manager or the HR. Next section up is the appraisal form. In the appraisal form, you will first see that you are actually the one doing the self-appraisal and your appraiser will be Ben. You will also see that there are 9 steps to complete in order to complete your appraisal. So once again, giving you visibility in terms of the progress as you are completing it before you can actually submit your appraisal. What is your appraisal form constituted of? First, open-ended questions. Once again, this will have been set up in advance by your HR administrator, so you will only have to give your answers. On the left side of this appraisal form will be all the self-appraisal, your own comments across those open-ended questions, the KPIs, the competencies, and even the summary. Once the manager has completed also the appraisal, you will be able to see your manager's comments, or at least your appraiser's comment, on the right-hand side, so that it will be very clear side by side what is the self-appraisal, what is the manager appraisal, and what is the overall outcome of this appraisal. So open-ended questions could be in the likes of, what do you think you have learned during this cycle? To which you can add your comment very easily. I have learned a lot. You can save as you go. As you have not submitted your appraisal yet, you can actually come back to it and edit your answer. You can also go literally out of the performance management page and come back to fill up the rest of the appraisal form in a later stage. So it's very convenient. You don't have to spend 2, 3, 5 hours in a row thinking about what you've done this year. You can actually go for it progressively. We can see that the progress is not 1 out of 9 since we just completed this part. Then objectives. This will automatically pick up the objectives that we have seen earlier and include them in the appraisal form. Implement digital marketing program, bring your best self every day, set up and follow a learning plan. If I don't quite remember my key results on this specific objective, rather than going back and forth, I can easily click on this little tag here, which will make all the results appear. So now I know exactly what is the details of the key results, and I can then add my self-comment and rating. I have performed well, yet need to do more efforts on the first part. You can then give yourself a rating and save your result. Repeat that for each objective. Competency is next. If you remember, we had 4 competencies. Level 2 with my expectations. Fosters collaboration. Here are my expectations. I can then add my own self-rating. So I demonstrated that I can foster collaboration. I give myself a self-rating of 4 out of 5 and I save. I can go on, and actually I can even see that I have a guide as to what rate means what in my company. Your company will decide the rating scale, will even decide the description of each of the rating items, so that you know exactly what you should and how you should evaluate yourself. Finally, you can leave a summary in terms of an overall comment on your self-appraisal. I did very well this first half 2022. And save your comment. That's it. Now you can submit your appraisal if you want, although we have not completed everything. We can submit our appraisal. We have only completed 4 out of 9 steps for the sake of this demonstration. But when we actually submit, I will be asked to confirm in order to avoid submitting with mistakes in it or submitting involuntarily. Once submitted, my manager will be able to actually then add comments, and later on in the process, when this appraisal form will be released to me by my manager, I will be able to see side by side my self-appraisal as well as the manager appraisal. The last section in the performance management is the one-on-one feedback. It's very simple. Whenever you have a discussion with your manager or with your direct reports, you can come back and decide to add comment here. Great discussion around priorities for next month, for instance. You can, of course, go into more details. This is really for the sake of the training video, but it allows to track during the year, throughout the year, all the discussions that happens between yourself and your manager, which makes sure that by the end of the year, or by the end of, again, the quarter or any performance cycle duration, it is a formality to complete your performance management review, because everything has been discussed and has been updated and documented as you go. Some companies do it weekly, monthly, quarterly. When it's done yearly, it works as well, just that you potentially have a bit more to remember from.